A big thank you to InstaWP for sponsoring this video. InstaWP is a great way to create, test, and deploy WordPress websites in just one click. A few days ago, I was hunting for design inspiration and I stumbled across the most beautiful one-pager website I think I've ever seen. And there was one aspect of it that completely blew me away. It was a Glassmorphic menu. So today, I'm going to show you how to build it. There are just three simple steps to build your very own beautiful Glassmorphic menus, and those are build your sticky menu structure. I'm going to take you through these step by step. How to create the Glassmorphic background, the frosted glass effect. I'm going to show you a really cool, cheaty way to do that. And then how to apply that to your menu. There is also a big bonus at the end, so make sure you stay on and watch that. So for this demo, I'm using the 2024 default theme, but you can do this on any block theme. So I'm going to start off at the top and I'm just going to add the group block. This is my main container. And I'm actually going to make this sticky straight away. So just come across to the right and then choose sticky. You'll see this in the options here if you click on that little cog there. And then within that group block, I'm actually going to add a row block. This is going to house my actual navigation. So add the row block and I'm just going to center this by that little icon there. Now I'm just creating the structure at this point, but within that row block, I actually want to create another group block. So I'm just going to select the group block here. And now we're finally ready to add my navigation block, which I've actually already built. So I'm just going to add that in here. So this is my navigation block. Let me open this up so you can see how I've built this. So I've just got within that, I've got the social icons block here. And I've just added the WordPress logo. And then all I've got is a bunch of pages. And then I've got the buttons block at the end. This buttons block, though, I have added some styles to it. You can see I've added a radius of 25. But this main group block at the moment that contains my navigation hasn't got any styling on it at all. So even though it's sticky, as we're going to see in a minute, it doesn't have that frosted glass effect. We also need to add some curves to this menu. Now I've added a background color just so we can see what we're doing before we add the glass effect. I've selected the group block here. And what we need to do is come across to the right and we need to come to radius and we're going to put a radius of 50. And that gives us our lovely curved corners. So just to show you that it is actually sticky, I've added a cover block underneath it. And you can see as I scroll down, my menu is now sticking to the top, but we can't see it because it doesn't have any styling on it. So that's the next step. So this is where we're going to actually generate the CSS that we're going to apply to our menu to create that beautiful frosted glass effect. But don't worry, you don't have to learn any CSS. This does it all for us. You can see up here, this is the effect we're going to get. And then you just get these little sliders down here where you can pull them up or down and you see the amount of glassiness changes as you do that. So you can customize them. So just get the sort of glass effect that you want. Once you're happy, just click copy CSS to clipboard. But don't worry, you don't have to know any code at all to do this. I'm going to show you a neat cheat trick on how to apply this to your site. Now, if you know how to write CSS, you'll know exactly what to do with that code. But if you don't worry, here's a cheat way to add it to your site. Just hop over to ChatGPT, paste the code in and ask ChatGPT to add a class of type glass to it. And it'll generate the CSS you need for your website. And now there's just two simple steps to get your frosted glass menu working. Just go back to the menu that you built. Make sure you select this group block. This is the container of the actual navigation block. Then come across to the right, come to settings, that little option there. Come down here, and then you're just going to give it an additional class of glass. And then the final step is to add that CSS that we generated to your site. So just click on the global styles icon in the top right. Then you want to click on that little icon there where it says more. And now you want to click on additional CSS. And then all you have to do is paste that code in that you generated from ChatGPT. And here's the finished result. I think it looks absolutely stunning. I'm really happy with it. And as a bonus for you, I've created it as a free theme that you can download and use on your own sites. There is a link in the description below. Just click on that and you can download it along with some other great themes that I've created as well. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this one, if you can hit the like button now, it would be amazing because it does make a huge, huge, huge difference in terms of how many people get to see this video. It really, really does. So thank you if you can hit that like button. And also, every time you do hit that like button, our cats get a little treat. Remember, this Friday, we've got our first ever speed build challenge with Mike McAllister and Brian Cord. So check that out. It's Friday at 7 o'clock UTC time, 8 p.m. UK time. They get 30 minutes to recreate a website of my choosing. It's live. It's going to be really exciting. There's lots of jeopardy, so tune in for that, and I'll see you then. Thanks for watching. Keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.